It's Michelle Tiberge, and I'm going to show you how to get acrylic paint out of your carpet. So what happened here was, I'm in my art studio, I was gessoing, which is a word for priming, my wood panels back there, and I had plastic set out, and somehow my studio shoes got gesso on the bottom of them, and then I stepped all over, and so this little pattern is repeated in a few spots on this carpet. And I've been waiting till I could film this because I wanted to show you how easy it is to get paint out of the carpet. You'd be surprised, because it's an awfully scary thing when this happens. Especially if it's, I mean, this is just my studio carpet, so I'm not super concerned about it. But if this was at your home, you might be in trouble with someone. So we're gonna get you out of trouble today. All right, so I'm going to try a couple of things. Now, most people have alcohol on hand, so we're gonna try with alcohol. I know alcohol is a solvent for acrylics. My favorite thing, and I made another whole video on removing paint from fabrics and stuff with this, is the Winsor Newton Brush Cleaner and Restorer. And this is something that you can buy at art supply stores. I'll put a link below to show you where, somewhere online that you can find it, but you can buy it at most of your art supply stores or craft stores. So if in the US it's like Hobby Lobby probably has it, or Michaels or Blick or wherever, you can probably get it on Amazon. So I also just have some tools. I'm gonna use gloves just to protect my hands. I have a little scrub brush if needed, a little scrubby sponge, and a rag. So I'm gonna start, because I haven't tried this before with alcohol. I'm gonna see what happens with the alcohol. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take this side, and we'll try alcohol. That's why I put the tape there, so we can compare the difference in their effectiveness. And this side for the brush cleaner. This, they both should soak for a while. So we're gonna pour a little bit on these stains, and I'll try and keep this on this side. Whoa, whoa, okay. And then pour a little bit over here. This is the brush cleaner and restorer on this side. And let that soak in. By the way, I keep a small bottle of this in my closet for stains on my clothes, because since I'm painting almost every day, inevitably I come home and take something off and I'm thinking, oh no, I didn't realize I got paint on it. So I'll just soak things and leave them in the hamper and then scrub them off a little before I put them in the washing machine, and stuff tends to come out. So we're gonna let that sit. It's about 11:25 right now. I'm gonna come back in maybe 20 minutes and check on these. Okay, hi, so Joanne is here with me, and I was showing her how quickly the Winsor Newton stuff worked on these other stains, and we already got one off, and that was just 2 minutes. And I thought, well, I should just show you how quickly this stuff works. I don't know about the alcohol, but again, that might be what you have. So let's just test on the alcohol. I'm using my knife because this dried months and months ago. Oh, by the way, it would be really wise to test this on an area of your carpet that no one can see, maybe something that's under some furniture or something, because I don't know how these chemicals will react with the dyes and the fibers in your carpet. So don't take it for granted that this can't hurt your carpet. So this is actually doing pretty good. Look, check this out. What do you think about, Joanne? You wanna chime in based on what you saw of using the brush cleaner on the other stain? How do you think this is working in comparison?
It's pretty good. It doesn't look quite as clean as the brush cleaner.
Yeah.
Like, it seems to come off a little cloudy.
That maybe because there's more paint on this stain. Try this side just to be fair. So I'm using this kind of scrapey tool because basically what happened is the paint has dried and it's just on the outside of the fibers. It's not sunk in. Here's something to know. Now, if you have a staining color, this will not work as well, because basically you'll just dilute the stain and make like a phthalo blue, a phthalo green, some kind of black, a lot of reds stain. And this white is not a staining color, so it just dried, the pigment dried on the surface, and it can be lifted off. But if you have a staining color, you could make a bigger mess. Did you ever read that story, The Cat in the Hat Comes Back, when you were a kid?
It's a great story. I love Dr. Seuss. Anyway, it's about a stain, and they get the stain off, and then it goes on the dress, and then they wash out the dress in the bathtub or something like that. I probably have it wrong. I haven't read it in many years. But anyway, it can be kind of like that. You might just be making a bigger mess. So I'm going to just try. And I didn't even put my gloves on, but I'm using tools. So, okay.
If you were to like dab while cleaning off a staining color, mm-hmm. would that prevent it from spreading?
Maybe a little. It's just not, I don't want to like cause more problems for anybody, you know, especially if it's like an important area of your home. And in that case, you might want to seek a professional. I'm just talking about like things that, okay, so this is the alcohol on this side. So we'll rub this side a little. I tend to agree with you, Joanne. Like, this seems a little cloudier. It's not lifting quite as well. But hey, if it's what you have on hand, if you're like me and you're an artist and you're using paint all the time, I would definitely invest in a bottle of the brush cleaner and restorer, because it not only gets stains off your clothes and your carpet, but it cleans your brushes really well. And it works on oil or acrylics. The alcohol would only work on acrylic paint, not on oil paint. So if you spilled oil paint. The other advice is wait until the stain is dry to try this technique, because you'll also be just smearing it and making a big mess if you try and do it on wet paint. I mean, sometimes you can flush out the stain immediately, you know, if you get it. But for something like a non-staining color, this is easier, and there's our little in-between spot. So you can kind of compare the difference between the two. So I definitely feel like it seems a little whiter and lighter. This seemed to really lift a little better, but again, if you have the alcohol in hand, it's definitely worth a try. And this was my toughest stain. It had the most paint on it, so that's why we used it for the video. Okay, so I just wanted to let you know that both of these products are non-toxic, so they can be used around children and pets. And this has been on here, we think, for about, what do you say, Joanne, 6 minutes?
Five, six minutes.
So this has just been soaking on here, and it's just amazing how quickly the stain comes off. And then, I have not even had a residue be left, but obviously, you know, at some point you might want to steam clean your carpet or whatever. I think there's a little bit more. This one is a little tougher stain, but the lighter stains came off really fast. Okay. It's also, this stuff is biodegradable, the brush cleaner and restore. That's a big issue for me. I try and use things that are non-toxic and low environmental impact if I can, as much as possible. And it's just nice to know that there's something that can get this stain without a lot of work. Okay, cool. Well, I have a few more. I won't bore you with this, but I'm gonna show you my car seat next. I got some paint on my car seat, and that has also been on there for a long time because I wanted to film a YouTube video showing you me getting it off the car seat. Hopefully it'll work. All right, so I am a pretty sloppy painter. So not only did I get the gesso on the carpet, but somehow when I was driving home from the studio, I got paint on the seat of my car. And this is how much I love my YouTube people. I waited for months and months. I didn't clean this off because I really wanted to wait until I could have someone kind enough like Joanne to film this to show you, because I know this is going to work. I know it's going to be great and my seat will be back to normal, but I've been walking around with a dirty seat, or driving around with a dirty seat. Okay, so we're going to, again, we have to just saturate it with this brush cleaner and restorer stuff. Saturate. And you need to let it sit for a few minutes, so we'll take a little break and we'll come back to this. Okay, it's probably only been about 90 seconds, but I'm too impatient, and I was talking to Joanne and I was like scraping, and she's like, wait, let me turn on the camera. So probably you could wait longer, but I just want to do something about this problem. So yeah, it's pretty dried on there. It's a thicker, the carpet, because the fibers, the paint kind of stuck to the outside of some bigger fibers. This is more embedded in a lot of small fibers, so really, I'm being too impatient. I need to let this sit for longer. I'm getting some off. What do you see?
There's a little bit coming off.
Yeah. We'll wait a little longer on that. Okay, so I'm really impatient. It's only been about 8 minutes, and I was like, let's go back and test it, but it's not really giving it that much time to soak in, so I'm going to pour a little more on, actually, and then I'll tell a little story about how I saved myself from disaster with this stuff one time. So, I used to travel teaching acrylics, and I had to rent a car, and I had on the back there, I had done some sample paintings and I really liked them and I wanted to save them. So they were in these cardboard, shallow cardboard boxes with plastic lining them. And I stuck them, what do you call that part of the back of the car?
I have no idea. The back
anyway,
of the car.
That part there above the seats, that horizontal part. And I don't know what happened at some point when I was driving, maybe I went on a hill or something, and they tilted and fell off, and all the pouring medium and paint started pouring down the side, the seat of my rental car. And I like flipped out. I was like, oh no, I've ruined it. Oh my God, I've ruined this rental car. I'm gonna owe them all this money. So I cleaned it up really fast, and I literally had a bottle of this, or might have had to go buy a bottle of it, and I just saturated the back of the seat with it, and I cleaned the whole thing off. They never were the wiser. The whole thing got cleaned and it was fine. I think I probably like washed it with, rinsed it with, it was black. So, black seating. And I think I probably did like a little soap and water after, cause this has like a slight oily residue to it. So let's look again. We'll see where we are. A little misimpatient here. Can't wait very long. This is one of those type of stains that might take a little more work than the carpet for the reasons I said, because the smaller fibers, there's more places to grab. Ooh, whoa, that's doing pretty good. What do you think, Joanne?
Yeah, it's coming off pretty well.
Yeah. There's still a bit on there, and I certainly let it sit for months and months, so it might have been a little easier sooner. But I know this is going to come off with some persistence. It might just mean more soaking and more coming back. I like this tool because it's scraping the paint off of the fibers. I think I like it better than the scrub brush. I brought all those tools in just thinking that I would just grab for whatever intuitively felt right. But it feels like this knife is the most efficacious thing. This is a palette knife, by the way, if you're not a painter and you're watching this, but you could use a butter knife or whatever you have on hand. I've used my fingernail before, but that's not being very nice to your fingernails, so I'm trying to demonstrate best practices here. Okay, we'll come back to this later, but it's much cleaner. What do you say?
Definitely much cleaner, yeah.
Okay, I'm going to rub it with a rag just so people can see. We have this oily residue that will evaporate, and again, if you can always clean it off with soap and water to get rid of that, or I can have it steam cleaned, which I might have to do at some point. We'll try and let you know the results of that if we're here long enough today. But whoa, so much better already. So much better already. Now I know, not driving around with this big white paint stain on my car, but I don't really care. I'm an artist. I don't care what people think about how clean my car is. I just care about how I feel about it. And I like to have a clean car, but that didn't bother me for some reason. Okay, we'll check back. All right, so we are back. And before I left, we poured more of the brush cleaner and restorer on the stain. And you can see, compared to how it was in the beginning, it's largely disappeared. So it's been soaking. How long would you guess?
40 minutes.
40 minutes, okay. And I'm just doing a little more scratching with the knife. I think at this point there's not so much of the actual paint particles. It's just a little bit of the residue of the white on there. I'd like to get it totally off. I'm not 100% satisfied. It is so much better. But there's, you can see a little bit there. There, it was so small you could hardly see it. I'm just not sure at this point. I'm inclined to use a little soap on it, because I think as far as what the brush cleaner can do, we got most of it. Yeah. So I'm gonna have to let that dry out a little bit and try soap and water. And I can always go back in with a brush cleaner and try that too. So it just depends on to what degree. I would say it's pretty good. What's your take on it? You're sitting here.
I think if you didn't know it was there, it would be very hard to notice.
Yeah. But we know it was there, right? And we still, and there was when we came in, you could see that little kind of halo. Mm-hmm. This stuff has just a slight, it's like, I don't know, it's like slight detergent-y or like slight oiliness to it. So it might leave a residue on this upholstery. You don't really see it on the carpet. But that's why I would go in with soap and water and a rag and stuff like that and try and clean that off. But I would let it evaporate more and dry out a little bit before I try and do that. So, but I'm pretty pleased. I hope that helps. I hope if you guys have any upholstery mishaps, this might help. As always, I'm always telling you this, and please take my advice. Test it on something. If you've never used this before, try and find an area that won't show, you know, like something back here or something, where you just put a little dab of it and let it, you know, make sure. We just don't know what your upholstery is or what the surface is. You're always better off testing rather than making a grave mistake because you jumped in without pre-testing it on an inconspicuous area. So that's always my best advice, whether it's a carpet or upholstery or a piece of clothing. Always try out whatever you're using first on an area where you won't notice if there's any damage. I personally have never had any problems. I've used this on cashmere, corduroy, denim, upholstery, carpets. I've never had any problem with it, but I don't want you to be the exception to the rule. So I hope that helps, and good luck getting your stains out.